Another favorite supposed proof of ball earthers is the appearance from an observer on shore of ships' hulls being obfuscated by the water and disappearing from view when sailing away towards the horizon. Their claim is that ships' hulls disappear before their mastheads because the ship is beginning its declination around the convex curvature of the ball earth. Once again, however, their hasty conclusion is drawn from a faulty premise, namely that only on a ball earth can this phenomenon occur. The fact of the matter is that the law of perspective on plane surfaces dictates and necessitates the exact same occurrence. For example, a girl wearing a dress walking away towards the horizon will appear to sink into the earth the farther away she walks. Her feet will disappear from view first, and the distance between the ground and the bottom of her dress will gradually diminish until, after about a half a mile, it seems like her dress is touching the ground as she walks on invisible legs. The same happens with cars speeding away, the axles gradually getting lower and the wheels vanish until it appears as if the car is gliding along its body. Such is the case on plane surfaces. The lowest parts of objects receding from a given point of observation necessarily disappear before the highest. David Wardlaw Scott says, "This law of perspective meets us on every hand and cannot be gainsaid. If, in a straight line, we look at a frozen lake from a certain distance, we shall observe people who appear to be skating on their knees, but if we approach sufficiently near, we shall see them performing graceful motions on their feet. Farther, if we look through a straight tunnel, we shall notice that the roof and the roadway below converge to a point of light at the end. It is the same law which makes the hills sink to the horizon as the observer recedes, which explains how the ship's hull disappears in the offing. I would also remark that when the sea is undisturbed by waves, the hull can be restored to sight by the aid of a good telescope long after it has disappeared from the naked eye, thus proving that the ship had not gone down behind the watery hill of a convex globe, but is still sailing on the level of a plain sea." Not only is the disappearance of ships' hulls explained by the law of perspective, it is proven undeniably true with the aid of a good telescope. If you watch a ship sailing away into the horizon with the naked eye until its hull has completely disappeared from view under the supposed curvature of the earth, then look through a telescope, you will notice the entire ship quickly zooms back into view, hull and all, proving that the disappearance was caused by the law of perspective and not by a wall of curved water. Samuel Robotham says, "On any frozen lake or canal, notably on the Bedford Canal, in the country of Cambridge, in winter and on a clear day, skaters may be observed several miles away, seeming to glide upon limbs without feet. Skates and boots quite invisible to the unaided eye, but distinctly visible through a good telescope. But even on the sea, when the water is very calm, if a vessel is observed until it is just hull down, a powerful telescope turned upon it will restore the hull to sight, from which it must be concluded that the lower part of a receding ship disappears through the influence of perspective and not from sinking behind the summit of a convex surface." Ball earthers will often also quip that if the earth were flat, then we could see all over it. But this is, of course, ignorant and inaccurate. If you stand on the beach, a plain or prairie, you will find the horizon extends about 3 to 6 miles around you, depending on the weather and your eyesight. The range of the human eye, our field of vision, is from 110 to 1 degree, and the smallest angle under which an object can still be seen is 1/60th of 1 degree. So that when an object is 3,000 times its own diameter away from an observer, it will cease to be visible. So for example, the farthest distance at which one can see a 1-inch diameter penny is 3,000 inches, or 250 feet. Therefore, if a ship's hull is 10 feet above the water, it will disappear from the unaided eye at 3,000 times 10 feet, or 6 miles. This has nothing to do with the supposed convexity or curvature of the earth, and everything to do with the common law of perspective. Thomas Winship says, "The horizon of an observer is distant or near according to the greatness or otherwise of his elevation above the surface of the supposed globe. If he stands 24 feet above sea level, he is said to be in the center of a circle which bounds his vision, the radius of which in any direction on a clear day is 6 miles. A local gentleman tells me that he has watched a boat race in New Zealand, seeing the boats all the way out and home, the distance being 9 miles from where he was standing on the beach. I have seen the hull of a steamer with the naked eye at an elevation of not more than 24 feet, at a distance of 12 miles, and in taking observations along the South African coast, have sometimes had a horizon of at least 20 miles at an elevation of 20 feet only. The distance of the horizon, or vanishing point, where the sky appears to touch the earth and sea, is determined largely by the weather, and, when that is clear, by the power of our vision. This is proved by the fact that the telescope will increase the distance of the horizon very greatly and bring objects into view which are entirely beyond the range of vision of the unaided eye. But as no telescope can pierce a segment of water, the legitimate conclusion we are forced to arrive at is that the surface of water is level, and that therefore the shape of the world cannot be globular, and on such a flat or level surface, the greater the elevation of the observer, the longer will his range of vision be, and thus the farther he can see. Samuel Robotham says, "On the shore near Waterloo, a few miles to the north of Liverpool, a good telescope was fixed. At an elevation of 6 feet above the water, it was directed to a large steamer just leaving the River Mersey and sailing out to Dublin. Gradually the masthead of the receding vessel came nearer to the horizon until at length, after more than 4 hours had elapsed, it disappeared. The ordinary rate of sailing of the Dublin steamers was fully 8 miles an hour, so that the vessel would be at least 32 miles distant when the masthead came to the horizon. The 6 feet of elevation of the telescope would require 3 miles to be deducted for convexity, which would leave 29 miles, the square of which, multiplied by 8 inches, gives 560 feet. Deducting 80 feet for the height of the main mast, and we find that, according to the doctrine of rotundity, the masthead of the outward-bound steamer should have been 480 feet below the horizon. Many other experiments of this kind have been made upon seagoing steamers, and always with results entirely incompatible with the theory that the Earth is a globe."